First thing I'm going to do is just pop down a little bit of masking tape. Just to get into the spine, to protect the spine, to protect the other pages from the red colour that might leak through. And all that. So thinking about leaking through, should I gesso? I think gesso would be a good place to start. Yeah, let's just gesso. Remove that out of the way. Gesso. Let's grab some paper to go. Ooh, don't know what that was. Can I do this? Yeah. Some gesso, because this is obviously not a mixed media paper, it's just a book paper really, and it's kind of thin, and I think gesso will just add that extra layer of strength and a base layer for us to paint on, and it will also disguise that masking tape a little bit. Just slapping it on. Who knows when I'm gonna actually get time to sit down and edit these videos. So I've got no idea when you're gonna be watching this. Well, it is January the 24th today, and it is so dark outside. So dark and grey and yuck. At least it's not as foggy as it was the other day. Oh, that was kind of frightening. And there's no ice today. It's been a bit frosty the past few mornings, and then we had the fog, and then the frost disappeared, which was good. Okay. That's a really thick and horrible layer. Gesso. So I'm going to let that dry and gather some red supplies. Okay, so I'm going to start a little differently to how I usually start. I'm going to grab my new stamp for Christmas. And I'll pop her up here. And pop that just about fits on the block. Just about. There we go. I'm going to grab some black. Stays on, it's gonna work today. haven't used this for ages. And now it's dried up. So yeah, as well as using just one colour, we are using black and white as well, so. I'm going to start putting black, hopefully. Juicy, juicy. I just put that box, I've just moved it, there it is. Just clip my hair off a little bit. Okay. Now. Going to work around her a little bit. And I want this stamp. Nope. It's a visible image stamp. Sorry. Forget. Shall we use the block? Yeah, I just put the block, should I put it away? Then? I've just seen it, where is it? Okay, oh, okay, here it is. I'm going to use a red for this. The candied apple, if I can find it. Must be that one, yep. Distress ink. Some almost a border, but not a full border. It's like a hint of a border, if you will. Secondary stamping there. Okay. Now I'm going to grab another stamp, which was in the little book. Here it is. Just a little love heart. The red can be quite an overwhelming colour, so I'm not overdoing it. I'm going in quite subtle to begin with, and we'll build it up, I think. I've got some red washes as well, which I may use. I'm not 100% sure on that. Now I'm going to grab a red pen. No paint yet. No, then which red? Let's go for this more deeper red. I'm just going to colour these flowers in. Red roses. I'm not going to colour any of the rest of the image, just the roses, because obviously red, black and white are all we can do. And I think it would be quite nice to have the black and white image with this red pop. And while some colouring ideas are coming to my head for how I want to do the next bit, tiny red roses on laces there. Probably colour her, I'm not sure. Just thinking about giving her a dress, maybe a hint of red. No. I'll leave it at the flowers, I think. Right. And actually, I think I'm going to grab that washi tape now. Girly, a bit of grounding. I like that, and then of course just add a bit of balance. Pop a bit of that over there. And now this side. So now I need to decide which of my stencils I'm going to use. I think actually I might use this one. That's a bit small. Let's just go with that one. A nice arrangement to it as well. So I'll grab, if I can get it out, here we go, some fibre paste. Before I do that, let me grab, now I know I've had the masking tape out, so there's that. Okay, let's see if we can do it with this washi. Mask out the leaves, I think. Just want the flowers. Do grab a spatula, which is very dirty. try and get another one in without squishing the other ones. Have one more. Kind of squash that one, but never mind. Okay, so just need that to dry and I'll be back. So that's just drying off a little bit more. And I thought I'd just add these little roses. Napkin roses. Oh, and I'm gonna, muck that up. That's okay. Cover it up so it's fine. This helps. Now, I just need to grab out some paints. I'll be back in a sec. Okay, so I'm just going to pop out a little bit of white paint. Stencil back out, pop that over the fibre paste, to make sure that that white colour stands out, because the fibre paste kind of takes a bit of the background on, so it's not exactly white. I don't want the roses to be white. Better, and then grab the other stencil. Which way did we do it? That way? Yeah, that way. To go back in with this one, don't we? Which one did we use? That one. And now I want that to dry. Dry completely, and then we're going to add some red. Okay, so whilst I'm waiting for that to dry, just had the idea to add a bit of intense pencil around the girl, and I'll do it around the roses as well. Maybe when they're dry, or maybe now. I don't know. And that's going to kind of give her a bit more grounding on the page. So I've got a water brush. It's a bit wet. Just drag that colour outwards a little bit. So I found my stencil that I was thinking about using. Get that out of the way. I don't need that for this. Not sure it was, but now I found it. Yay! So I'm just gonna add some black into the page. That stays on. Just that's it. To complement our girl there. Something just to bridge these two pages. I like that. Now, is this dry yet? Yes. So. My stencil got in that paint. Lovely. Let's grab that small brush. Let's use this one. This will do. Grab some red paint. Just deciding where to put the red. butter. And a fan brush. Cover the lady up. I can't do this. So I'll let that dry again, and then I think I'll come back with some black outlining. Okay. Let's do some outlining on these roses. I think we'll just go back around the shape. So I'll put some red paint out and some water down a little bit. I'm just gonna pop some in a couple of places. And grab a spray bottle. Hope that black ink is dry enough, which I don't think it is. Oh well. I'm not sure it's gonna run. The paint's not running, but the Inktense pencil is. bag it. Look who's sitting amongst my mess. Where's the journal? Okay, so I think I'm just gonna wait, all right. Yeah. And let's use the date stamp. Today is the 24th January 2020. First time we're using this stamp this year. Archival. Just make sure I've got everything the right way around. Let's get around this rose. There we go. And I'm happy to call that page done. So it's a red page with actually quite a bit of white space. I hope you enjoyed that video. Please remember to subscribe if you want to see more. Check out the rest of the videos in the series. And thank you for watching. Bye guys.